Everybody, this is Crystal Proxmire of Oakland County Times. We're here today with Joseph Solis Mullen, who is running for U.S. Senate. How are you today?
I'm good, Crystal, for me today.
Good. Well, thank you for being here. Can you just tell us why have you decided to run for Senate?
I was asked to do it by some colleagues. They wanted someone who could represent the party ideologically in a way that was coherent and who could platform our ideas in a race that we think really is good for highlighting how we are different from Republicans and Democrats, because sometimes that can be something of a challenge, especially because most people aren't entirely familiar with the Libertarian Party. So,
What is some of your professional experience and the skills that you bring to the table?
I'm an economist and political scientist at the Libertarian Institute. I've written a couple of books about, frankly, rather timely topics, about the national debt, about China. I'm also a professor of history. So this is my first time running for public office. So I don't bring any specific experience in that way. But I did graduate from a public policy school. I have multiple graduate degrees in all of these subjects. So I've covered a wide variety of issues over the years, going back, gosh, half a decade. If you Google my name, you can very easily find my thoughts on anything from monetary policy, fiscal policy, regulation, foreign policy. It's just I've been a public figure for, as I said, for almost a decade. So it's very easy to find information if you're curious about one of my policy positions. I've probably written about it.
What are some of the ways that you've been involved in the community?
Well, we're involved through our church, and I'm also the coach of the local youth soccer club. And that's really it in terms of our involvement in the community. In that way, obviously, we show up for different public events. Our civic the civic life in our town is pretty robust. So there's something going on in terms of or weekly involvement. Those are the two main ways.
Some of the things that you'd like to work on if you're elected.
Well, realistically, I think it's a huge challenge for any third party candidate who got elected, especially a Libertarian Party candidate, because of course no one senator has any real power to. I think that there are a couple of things that are just sort of on their face, self-evidently problematic, but that don't receive really any attention. And so I think a candidate like myself, were they to get a seat, their job would be to try and push these things forward and make them a constant topic on the agenda. One of the biggest things is the national debt. This is something that I don't know how long your readers or how old they are, how long they've been paying attention to politics, but I can remember back 20 years ago when the $7 trillion mark, and it was, everyone was going catatonic about it. Now we're closing in on 36 trillion, and it's not even in the paper. This is not sustainable. This is not even the true national debt. There are all sorts of unfunded liabilities that total almost $200 trillion that the government is on the hook for. No one wants to talk about these things because talking about making cuts to entitlement programs, talk about shrinking the size of government, talk about maybe even raising taxes. These are things that are not going to get you reelected. It's better to just let the Federal Reserve finance the debt and kick the can further and further down the road. But that's what's been happening for 20 years now, and it's just not sustainable.
In this race, you're going up against incumbents and people from the bigger parties. Why should the voters pick you?
Well, on the topic of the debt, both of them were actually part of the problem. Mike Rogers voted to fund every single one of George W. Bush and Barack Obama's idiotic wars that cost trillions of dollars, voted for every continuing resolution, every omnibus spending package. And since he arrived, Alyssa Slotkin has been the same. And it's because they really perfectly represent the uniparty consensus between Republicans and Democrats. That is, that the wars will continue, that the big spending will continue, and that the massive system of government surveillance that exists will also continue. And if you are committed to these pillars of what has become the American state, you can't cut spending. You can't make serious changes. So you're just forced to keep kicking the can down the road and focusing on really divisive social issues, saying that they're going to take your guns or they're going to stop you from having an abortion, because that's really all they can say. They don't really disagree on anything else. And for better or for worse, that is how many voters make their decisions. I'm well aware of the behavioral literature on politics, which tells me that voters are rationally irrational about political behavior. And it is one of the reasons that I do not hold out strong hopes for a rational appeal to make any real headway, because it is more fun, it is psychologically more beneficial to the individual to simply cheer for their team and hate the other side with all the passion that they can, like they're cheering for their favorite sports team. So, but that is in large part how we got in this mess. And so we have to make some changes, otherwise it's going to be very messy. And so hopefully voters will at least take into consideration the possibility that voting for more Democrats and Republicans, when it is Democrats and Republicans who got us into this mess, might not be the best way forward.
If the voters want more information about you and your campaign, where can they go?
Well, Solis Mullen for Senate, that's the number four, my name and the number four is my campaign website. There's all sorts of things on there about like policy positions, upcoming talks. I have one coming up in Ann Arbor here in I believe 2 weeks about the drug war and its futility. They can also check me out on Twitter. That is where I post most of my work stuff. So I write a column every week at the Libertarian Institute. Again, it's usually about monetary or fiscal policy or China. So it's timely. It's timely stuff. And if people are again curious, what do I think about these issues? It's right there. So that's at Solis Mullen, at Solis underscore Mullen at Twitter. And that's it. I have many public email addresses. If you just Google me, it's very easy. I get emails every single day. If I don't respond right away, it's because I have literally six emails, and sometimes you wind up in a spam folder. So just be patient.
Perfect. Well, I thank you for taking the time to talk with us today.
Thanks for making the time, Crystal. I appreciate it.